Hi, and welcome to a very special holiday gift-giving edition of Two Blondes Drink Beer. Today, Kara and I are sadly not right next to each other because of this stupid pandemic, but we're still going to do this, and it's still going to be fun.
Yeah.
All right, so what we're going to do is try to give you guys ideas for different beer-related gifts that you could give all of those loved ones in your life. Right, Kara?
Yes, for the beer lover and even for the non-beer lover in your life.
You got a special one there, too.
Yeah.
All right, so we both just kind of chose some beers to drink while we do this.
Yeah, we're going to drink a beer while we tell you about all these great gifts, right? But we're not going to review the beer we're drinking. We're just going to drink it.
No, we're just going to straight up drink it because why not?
Yeah. What are you drinking today, Candy?
Oh, it's so good. Firestone Walker. This is the 2019 Velvet Merkin. And it's the bourbon barrel aged milk stout. They made an oatmeal stout too. This was in a special gift box set with several different versions of Velvet Merkin that I picked up at the liquor store. And this is one of those, I think it was a box of three. Delicious. What are you drinking, Kara?
Yum. Today I'm drinking a collaboration between Boulevard and Rheingeist, I think is how you say it.
Nice.
It's called Peach Berry Pie Sour Crust Fall. I guess it's called Crust Fall and the Peach Berry Pie Sour. And it's an Imperial Berliner style Weiss ale with peach, blackberry, blueberry, and other flavors, 7.5%. Never had it before. It's pretty tasty.
Awesome. I'm excited to try some of that if I can get my hands on it. You got another one anywhere?
I do. I've got another one just for you.
Awesome. All right, so I'm going to start us off because my beer happens to lead into one of our gift options. We've mentioned this as a pro tip before in at least one of our videos, if not more than one. But we both firmly, firmly believe that if you ever see Firestone Walker beer in a box, you buy the Firestone Walker beer in a box.
Like, do
that's
it.
Just a pro tip.
Yes.
Now, they aren't cheap. Oftentimes, these are beers that are like kind of behind the counter in a glass container, a display is what I'm trying to think of, a glass display. Regardless, it's kind of expensive for just a 16-ounce bottle of beer. So this is our luxury category. If you have that bougie friend who wants the best of the best, this would be a fantastic gift for them if they don't want to spend money on something that they're going to consume for themselves, then certainly if you're that type of friend, you buy them this nice luxury beer, they'll be impressed.
They will feel very special.
All right, Kara, what do you got over
there? Okay, for the Chiefs fan in your life, I have Worth the Wait from Boulevard, which is the celebratory beer for the Chiefs winning the Super Bowl, which was totally worth the wait. And so this is a perfect beer for that Chiefs fan in your life. If they already have all the gear, enough sweatshirts, enough Chiefs paraphernalia, they will love this gift. And this is still readily available around town. You can pick this up, so.
Yeah, and I'm sure that Boulevard distributed that elsewhere too. Since they won the Chiefs or the Super Bowl, I'm sure there's Chiefs fans throughout the U.S. now.
Yeah, they're everywhere. Who doesn't love Mahomes?
Who doesn't love him? He's fantastic.
Oh, he's such a great guy.
So I'm going to do the quintessential kind of bro craft beer gift.
Bro.
You know, bro.
What's up, bro?
It is very much a stereotype, and I'm normally against those, but let's be real, most men who are into craft beer really enjoy their IPAs. The hoppier, the better. And although it's not Kara and I's favorite, we've asked around, and the people we love who love IPAs feel like Dogfish Head 60-minute IPA is just a solid IPA for those people that you love. Now, we thought it would be fun to talk about different categories. So, like the acquaintance in your life who likes IPA, get them the 60-minute. It's a great beer, nice, solid IPA. For the more special friend, say a best friend who likes it, or somebody that you care about in your life a little bit more than just a coworker or acquaintance.
Yeah, maybe your brother.
A brother, sure. 90-minute. An uncle, fun uncle, maybe.
Yeah.
90-minute IPA. And then, for the significant other in your life, there is the 120-minute IPA, which Kara and I reviewed, and we can link the video.
Yeah.
This is really hard to find. It is more expensive. in my opinion, it tastes like straight up moonshine.
Pretty hot.
It's very alcoholy. But great gift ideas all around.
Yes. Yes. Okay, next up, for the chocolate lover in your life, the dessert lover, I've got a couple options for you. So, we have Oscar Blues, Death by Coconut. This is a great choice. We love this beer, and this is pretty widely available, I believe. So that's a great option. We also have Four Hands Chocolate Milk Stout. So Four Hands is out of St. Louis, and so they are pretty regional here in the Midwest, but I did realize they also distribute to some of the East Coast locations like DC and Pennsylvania. So if you're on that coast, you could probably pick this up. There are also some variations of this, so that would be really fun if you wanted to give the chocolate milk stout, and then in addition, another variation. So you give 2 6-packs. These are also pretty affordable for a 6-pack. And then another option, this is Left Hand Brewing, which is out of Colorado. So I think if you're more on the western part of the U.S., that these might be more readily available for you. This is the Chai Milk Stout on Nitro that we've reviewed. Nitro is always fun, so that makes a fun gift because it's kind of a fun experience while you're drinking it. And there are some variations of this as well. So again, you could do a couple different versions as a gift too. So these are all great for that person who might like a sweeter beer, you know, a little bit more on the chocolatey side.
Nice. And now I have a budget-friendly craft beer because times are tough. This year, they're even tougher than normal. And so if you want to get a craft beer lover a gift of craft beer, but you are tight on funds, Blue Moon is really a solid, solid beer. It is under $7 for a 6-pack. It's like under $14 for a case. It is a solid beer. It's easy to find. It's nationally distributed. And I would consider this a craft beer. Now, what I first thought of when I thought of this category was just Miller Lite. Miller Lite's a great beer, but it is not craft beer, so I don't feel like I could use that, but this one is. So pick up a 6-pack of Blue Moon, under $7.
All right, next up, for the non-beer lover in your life, but you still would like to gift something other than wine, we have a Radler. So Radlers are a mix of beer and like a lemonade or some other type of fruit.
Like citrus normally.
Yeah, like a citrus. So this one happens to be a grapefruit Radler from, I believe it's Stiegel. We were debating how to pronounce this.
How to say it.
Correctly. So from Stiegel. And so, but there's also, you can get like lemon Radlers and orange Radlers. And these would be a great gift for that person in your life who's not the biggest beer drinker, but does like to, you know, have something different. And I love that beer can be given instead of wine. Everyone always thinks of wine, which is great too, don't get me wrong, I love me some wine. but I think this is something different and something that they might not have received as a gift before.
Yeah. We have some non-beer items too that we just felt like you needed to know about.
Yes.
First of all, Brewmate makes these fantastic koozies that we're kind of obsessed with. Mm-hmm. They fit all of the tall, slim cans that were big, I think probably because of Truly's and what's the other?
Just all those hard seltzers
hard
that are
seltzers
out there
that were popular this year. But there's also quite a few beers that I like. The Bud Light makes a lime one that's delicious, actually. If you want something lighter, not a lot of calories on a hot day, this is fantastic. They're really well insulated, and then they have a non-skid kind of rubbery sole. So they come in a million different kinds. This one is mermaid glitter because that's how I roll. The Karen, I use these nonstop in the pool over the summer.
Yeah, we love those. They're awesome. Okay, next up, I have I wanted to show these paddles you can get that fit tasting glasses. So these are tasters. This one actually my husband made, and this is Coca Bolo, so it's a really fun, pretty wood. And then you can fit 3 tasters in this particular one. A lot of them will hold 4 or 5. You'll see these often at the breweries that you'll go to if you want to get a flight. And These are super fun if you're outdoors around a fire pit, enjoying some beers with some friends, and you want to share, like maybe you only have a couple bottles of something special, like a Worth the Wait or something else, and you want to share and try a couple different styles, or if you gifted a couple different versions or variants of a beer and you want to try them side by side, also super fun. So we use these tasting glasses and like little paddles that you can get all the time. They come in all kinds of fun, different woods that you can get. So you can get something to match your decor if you want. This one is curly maple. So those are always super fun. And then also, if you want to just get glassware in general, also great ideas.
I love it. Awesome. Good tips, Kara. Good tips all around. And a lot of just good, solid info there. The snootier you get into your beer journey, you will realize that people get very into glassware with certain types of beer. People get really into the temperature of the beer, which we've touched on before, but Kara and I just believe they should all be cold.
Yeah.
So yeah, I think that if you have somebody that you know is really into the science behind things or likes knowing how things work, that would be a perfect gift for them, giving them the correct glassware for the beer that they enjoy.
It's pretty funny because you mentioned us being snooty, and the beer I'm drinking out of today says beer snob.
Nice.
I don't even know where we got this or where it came from, but when I was going through the glassware, I found this, and I thought, you know, I'm just going to use that to drink my beer today.
I like it. All right, so we are too far apart to cheers, but we can both lift our glasses and say, hope that you find something for all of the loved ones in your life. Why not make it beer? Cheers!
Cheers!
Do we need something else?
I'm trying to think, is there anything else?
Oh, ho, ho! Merry Christmas! I don't know.